Hi, I'm Summer Wilson. I want to tell you about a funny story from my life. How I managed my teacher with the help of horoscopes, so I made her give me only good grades. And in general, she began to treat me differently. However, it didn't last that long. Well, about everything in order. There have been some personnel changes at our school. I used to have my own teacher in my class. As a leader, she was very cool. We loved her, but unfortunately, she quit, and we were introduced to a new teacher, Miss Vine. She was quirky, but what infuriated me the most was that she often found fault with us all. She had great demands on everything, down to appearance, handwriting, posture for writing. Miss Vine had us each day to take turns on duty in the classroom. She explained this by teaching children to do physical labor, cleanliness, and mutual respect. Parents liked this method very much, especially considering that now they did not have to pay for cleaning services. So, in a short time, she managed to wake up a whole class of students, a group of haters, with the exception of a few sycophants. She looked harmless enough, young, with fashionable red-rimmed glasses, and a formal skirt and blouse. Sometimes she was emotionally unstable, then yelled at us, and then immediately asked for forgiveness. She was constantly stuck in some obscure magazines. We were all interested to find out what was so interesting there. And one day, when all the teachers were called to a short meeting, my classmates and I went into her desk and found these magazines. I know it's bad to do this, but it's for a good cause. Oddly enough, we didn't find anything else there except horoscopes. At the same time, my classmate Andrew came up with an idea. If our teacher is so superstitious, why don't we use it? We discussed the plan, and when Miss Vine entered the classroom, we started talking about horoscopes without her noticing. Everyone saw her eyes light up. She asked if we believed it too, and we all waved our heads in the affirmative. Miss Vine immediately began to tell us about good sources that actually predict something useful. Then we offered her a more modern version. Why would you buy paper in the form of magazines? Wait for updates once a week, when you can watch horoscopes every day at hand. You only need the internet for this, I asked her. She said she didn't trust the network, but we assured her otherwise. She agreed to look there in the evening. After school, several classmates and I immediately gathered at my house, sat down at the computer, and created a social network page, Stars Speak, added a couple of pictures, searched for texts from different sources, and designed them beautifully. It looked very plausible. Closer to 11 o'clock in the morning, I saw Miss Vine subscribe to the group, and it meant that she was interested in the page. Then I began to come up with a horoscope for the morning, coming up with a text. First, I created a mini questionnaire to learn more about her. It turned out that our Miss Vine, according to the horoscope Leo, she is 35 years old, divorced, no children, lives alone, rents an apartment, believes in luck, and dreams of meeting the love of her life, but at the same time, hardworking, values reliability and loyalty in people. It immediately seemed to me that she got divorced precisely because she was betrayed. Well, that's not the point. When I woke up in the morning, I uploaded a pre-prepared text to the page for the Lions about her character, exemplary business on weekdays, and stressed that today she would refrain from violent emotions. Otherwise, it will negatively affect the rest of the day. The rest depended on the classmates. We had to adjust the actions around her to the horoscope. Thus, as soon as she entered the classroom, classmate Sean accidentally spilled pomegranate juice on her skirt, causing the beige skirt to color. The teacher was furious. Yes, it is what we need. We provoked her to violent emotions. Now her whole day was going to go downhill. We replaced her writing pens with non-writing ones while she was teaching. Flattened the wheel, smeared the chair with grease, left a rotten egg on the floor of her classroom, and hid it. We did everything we could to make sure she didn't have a good day. By the end of the lessons, she had faces on and was so upset that for a moment, we felt sorry for her. But it was all part of the plan, so you couldn't give up. At the last lesson, she came up to us and asked if we read our horoscope from this group. Of course, we said yes. I think it really works. Today wasn't my day, she said in a low voice. We reassured her that tomorrow would be better if she listened to our advice. The next morning, the following message was waiting for her. Dear Leo, today will be more pleasant if you relax a little. Don't overdo it at work. If possible, take a day off. And if you can't, make it as close to the day off as possible. You should not fight with the management. And if you meet children, let them relax with you. When she came to class, her smile showed that she had read our message. Our boys went ahead with the plan again, and they started paying her a lot of compliments. One of them gave her a bar of her favorite chocolate. Under the pretext that he allegedly mixed up her birthday, we distracted her, asked questions about her style, clothing, and at the same time, said compliments. The teacher blossomed. Then she said that today we can sit quietly on the internet. But only this will remain our common little secret. Hooray, we won! From that moment on, our manipulations continued. Every day we made up horoscopes, with hints about what to say to parents at a meeting. Cancel a test, do not give bad grades, do not ask or check homework, let everyone go home or do not come herself. It was a great time. We enjoyed our brilliant plan and our studies in general. Miss Vine threw away all her old magazines and liked her horoscope every morning. We didn't think about how long it would last. We just enjoyed the moment every day. But then something happened that we weren't prepared for. Our excellent ratings and reviews of Miss Vine attracted the attention of the headmaster. He knew our class and what we were capable of. He came into our classroom and told Miss Vine to run us through the topics. Wow, we didn't foresee this in the horoscope, I thought, and saw that the teacher was as confused as we were. We were unlucky in that the director was well-versed in literature, because he used to teach it himself. Miss Vine asked a question about a past topic, and no one knew what the topic was. What was it about? The awkward silence of the class made both her and us blush. We looked at each other anxiously, and the principal's face turned red with anger, more and more. After 10 minutes of silence, he began to raise one student and ask a question, but the result was the same. The director looked askance at the teacher and poked at the progress log. "And these grades? For what? They don't know anything. Nothing," he suddenly shouted. Our teacher even flinched. After a long yell, he left, slamming the door and saying that he would be back in 2 days and personally check on the preparations. That was the first time we saw our teacher's tears. "What the hell have we done?" the kid said during our after-school meeting. We asked each other how to fix the situation. "What should I do now?" Miss Vine was so confused. She sat with a pale face and was silent. We saw her digging on the internet, probably looking for a horoscope. The director came as promised. We, because we were not prepared, failed his exam. It was a crash. The director, in a rage, promised to fire Miss Vine. And then we realized that we had gone too far. The teacher burst into tears right in front of us, calling herself a fool. We were tormented by conscience, and I got up and said that we have something to confess. Vine and the director listened to my story in silence, and Miss Vine occasionally sighed and gasped, not forgetting to cry. I told everything as it is and took full responsibility for it. To my surprise, the rest of my classmates also came to my defense. We stood with our heads bowed. The director went to the blackboard, wrote the word horoscope, and below, "Tomorrow with parents to school, a serious conversation is expected. Try not to lie at the meeting, otherwise you will get in trouble." Then put a stop to it and left the class. Miss Vine burst into tears. It was the worst thing for her. She could lose her job because of our bad joke. All we have left is a heartfelt confession. After we received a massive response from parents and the principal, we begged not to fire Miss Vine, promising that we would run the entire literature program. The director kept his word. So now my classmates and I have been sitting here for several days in a row and making up for lost time.
My story may seem a little absurd because not every student has an affair with a teacher for good grades. Would you tell me it's disgusting? Listen to my story first. But before I start, subscribe to this channel. There are many more interesting stories here. So, my name is Emma. I am a student at one of the modest liberal arts universities. I am now in my third year. This story happened to me last year. When I went to university, I even could not think that I will be able to go to such lengths for the sake of ratings. I finished my first year with good marks, and my parents were so happy about it that they decided to support me and give me an incentive to become the best in the group. My father promised that if I finished the next school year perfectly, he would buy me a car that I had long dreamed of. Wow! I was delighted with this offer. It was another incentive for me. I mentally prepared myself for the new school year, bragged about everything to my friends. They supported me and told me to show the class to my parents. I was happy, and all because I was confident in my abilities. First of all, I chose the specialty of my choice, so it was easy for me to study. In principle, all subjects were easy for me, as long as they were humanitarian. Since childhood, I do not like numbers and do not know how to handle them. To be honest, I also chose the procession so that there was no need to solve all sorts of problems. But life is full of surprises. On the first day of our sophomore year, our head teacher called us together and announced a new schedule for the next day. What? Higher mathematics? Are you serious? What the fuck do we need it for? We are humanitarians! The headman just shrugged, and I felt that this math would ruin my entire deal with my parents. Getting really angry, I ran to the office of our curator and burst in shouting about why the hell do we need math? It turns out that there was a meeting where all the teachers of the department got acquainted with the mathematician. I literally froze in the doorway. The curator gestured that I was finished and shooed me away. And then I realized that I basically ride on minibuses too is not so bad because the car I now definitely do not see. I was nervous for the rest of the day, thinking only of my moment of shame. The next morning, I didn't even want to go to school, but I had to. I walked into the office and didn't even look up from the floor or in the direction of the teacher. First, he introduced himself.
My name is Stan Williams. I am your new teacher. You may be surprised what I do in your department and why the hell do you need my mathematics, but I will tell you right away. It is mathematics that surrounds us every day, and it is necessary in any sphere, he said, looking askance in my direction.
It's obvious to a fool that it was a rock in my garden. Then the teacher gave a short lecture on higher mathematics. Its history, need and difference from the usual one that is taught in secondary schools. While he was talking about numbers, my classmate Gladys poked me in the side and whispered in my ear, "What a beautiful mathematician." I grimaced. Personally, I only associated with him as well as with his subject, saying goodbye to my car. And Gladys kept saying, "No, look at him. He's such a good-looking guy. Young, not like us, of course, but young, fit, with a beautiful smile and neat. How can you not notice this? He must have someone," she said. I just pulled her back and told her to stop talking. At this moment, Stan Williams came up to us and made a remark for the behavior of only me.
"What? What the hell? Why me?"
I shouted out of resentment. And for that, he kicked me out of class. Since then, every pair of maths has been like a test for me, and Gladys seemed to be obsessed with the subject. She talked about him all the time, and even tried to ask him out a couple of times. When she told me about it, I called her crazy, and she said we were old enough to decide who we were going to have a romantic relationship with. In the meantime, a couple of months had passed, and my perfect grades were being ruined by C's and D's in math. I lost my patience when Stan Williams once again kicked me out of the office for allegedly bad behavior. I decided to stay after school and talk to him. I wasn't going to give up so easily. After waiting for the end of the session, I closed the door, went to the teacher, and asked a direct question about why was he so picky with me.
"It's not fair. Are you taking revenge on me for the time at your meeting when I called your subject unnecessary? Is that why you're dropping my grades?"
The teacher only laughed in response, and he said that if I wanted a good meal, I should agree to have dinner with him.
"What? Are you out of your mind? Is this harassment? I'll sue you, okay?"
I shouted and left, slamming the door. Gladys was waiting for me in the schoolyard. She saw my furious look and immediately asked what was wrong. After that, she told me to have dinner with him.
"I know you don't like him, but you won't lose anything if you eat with him," she said.
Perhaps there was some meaning in her words. I texted him that I agreed to tomorrow at 19 o'clock. To be honest, I was a little nervous all day. In the late afternoon, I put on my favorite black dress and he picked me up and we went to a restaurant. At first, I didn't know how to behave. We became so awkward. My teacher and I were having dinner together. What a shame. If someone finds out, then the gossip will not wash away. Stan Williams' voice distracted me from my thoughts. He started asking me about my family, hobbies. I didn't want to answer, but I had to at least try to be polite. Then our conversation gradually started on its own. It turns out that he was born in a poor family and earned his own education. He also works in parallel with another job in the evenings to send money to his parents.
I respected him after these words. My attitude to the topic at that moment changed a little. After that dinner, my grades changed too. He gave me more and more fives for almost nothing. Of course, this has been noticed by others, especially Gladys. She kept asking me what was going on between us. But nothing happened. We just had dinner, and that's it. 5 days later, he invited me to dinner again, then another, and another. We began to learn more about each other, so there were feelings, and we started dating. Rumors about our relationship spread all over the university. Gladys was most happy for us. My curator and the rector never called us to the carpet with the demand to stop this ridiculous affair. But it only added fire to our relationship. I didn't know anything about mathematics, but my grades were excellent, as was my relationship with Stan. A year later, my father, as promised, gave the car. But not only for good relations. It was a gift for our wedding.